Thank you, Charles. You know, we live in a great nation, and those of us who call McDuffie County and this region home, I think we live in one of the best parts of this great nation. My family and our extended family of about 200 employees have had the privilege of calling this place home for a number of generations. And this year, we celebrate our 75th year in the nursery business and started with our grandparents, my grandparents, Chris's and Beverly's grandparents. Also have my dad here, the second generation, Don Corwell, and Uncle Jack Corwell here. So we're so blessed to be part of this community. Well, a little earlier this year, a few months ago actually, I got a call from Linda Brown, who's with us here today. Linda is a board member with 10 Commandments, Georgia. And she was telling me about this program to display the founding documents and so forth. And the 10 Commandments, Georgia's mission to do this in every county in Georgia. Well, we listened and really liked what we heard. We talked about it a little bit, and we decided that, you know what, this is an opportunity for us to commemorate our 75th anniversary, but in a bigger sense, to say thank you to our community. And that's what we're able to do by presenting these documents. And it's a real privilege to have with us today our congressman, too, Congressman Jody Hice. And Jody is actually the founder of 10 Commandments, Georgia. This goes back from what I've read to 2003, when he was a pastor over in Bethlehem. No, not the one we're going to see about in Bethlehem in Barrow County, Georgia, just a few miles away from us. If you recall back in the news in that day and time, the ACLU sued the Barrow County government for commissioners for having a display of the Ten Commandments on their courthouse. And in part, I think Dr. Hice put together 10 Commandments, Georgia, to help with that and help with the legal defense. I think there's thousands of dollars of legal defense to defend that action. But as Paul Harvey might say, we'll pass over to Dr. Hice and let him tell the rest of
it. Thanks, Peter. Great to be here with Charlie, Don, Jack, and all of you. This is an exciting time. You know, the rest of the story, we had a couple-year battle in Barrow County, and we stepped up and created 10 Commandments, Georgia, to raise the money so the taxpayers in Barrow County would not have to pay for that legal battle. 2 years later, we lost the case after almost $300,000 battle, and the commandments came down in Barrow County. And at that point, the shift went to the state, and after another 6 years, we finally, in 2012, were able to be in the governor's office as he signed into law a statement that said these historical displays are legal anywhere in any government building in the state of Georgia. And so they went right back up in Barrow County. And they've gone up all over the place throughout the state. And, you know, this really is the foundation upon which our nation was established. And we've got to preserve that and educate it and keep these in the forefront. I cannot thank Tom Rush, who leads 10 Commandments, Georgia, and Linda Brown. I cannot thank them enough for their leadership and just all they do for this cause. And so with that, let me introduce you to Tom Rush. He leads up 10 Commandments, Georgia, and doing a great job.
Thank you, Congressman Hice. Listen, none of this with 10 Commandments, Georgia would have been possible without Congressman Hice's leadership in the beginning. And what 10 Commandments, Georgia now is that what we're doing, what we want to do, is to get the citizens of our state to know, obey, and display the 10 Commandments. We found out that if you put these documents up, these historical documents up, you will notice if you'll come back to the courthouse, you'll see people out here looking at them and reading them. And you can't obey something you don't know. And so we want the Ten Commandments to get out there. We think there are just a lot of people in our society that don't even know what the Ten Commandments are about or what they say. And this is a movement that has to be done by the citizens, the way the law has been established in our state. And so at Ten Commandments, Georgia, we're so grateful for the McCorkle family doing this, and other citizens across our state are doing this. We have the displays now in almost one-third of our 159 counties in Georgia, and our goal is to get the Ten Commandments up in every county in the state of Georgia through this historical display. So we encourage you to pray for us, and one of the ways that we make this happen is we get people on our board. By the way, if you'd be interested in serving on our board, please contact me. We need citizens that are interested in this and who are willing to work to make this happen. But several years ago, I heard from Linda Brown, and she was interested in what we were doing and wanted to know about it. And really, we just need to turn our whole organization over to Linda. She does a terrific job. And we're so grateful for the efforts that she has made. And she actually is an historian in her own rights, because she knows all of these documents, what their purpose was, and how each document builds on the other. The foundation of our law and government in the United States is the Word of God and the Ten Commandments. And it's all based on that. And Linda knows that so well. So we're so grateful for her efforts here, and grateful to the County Commission for your willingness to work with this and do the right thing and get these documents up. I want you to hear just briefly from Linda about her passion for the Ten Commandments.
Well, I know it's on the little agenda. But about my passion for doing this, and why do I have this kind of passion? And I imagine it's the same kind of passion that you each have, and that is that a love for God, a love for my family, a love for my country. And I have another love too. I was just looking out the window there while I was doing this, and I can remember as a little girl, maybe 8 years old, 2 years old, and I would just stand and look up at the sky and think, why am I here? What is the purpose? What is truth? That leads me to the fact that is going to be the very important to me, the truth. And so, a commitment to that truth. And when I got involved with these documents, this is a display of truth. And it begins with the Ten Commandments, right up there. And each one of these documents flows from that moral base. And so, I'm grateful that I have the opportunity to be a part of doing this. And somebody asked me about that I enjoy my work, whatever, and I said, this doesn't work. This is all the classic. Everywhere I go, every county commission that I've been able to speak to, I have been blessed. I go away and I go, wow, what I see is I see God in people. And I see people hungry for truth and hungry to want to defend their country. And so I'm just excited to be a part of this. And what I plan to do, I'm working on it, is a presentation on the document. So I'm going to go to the county and bring groups here and tell them what each one of these documents mean and why it's important that we know them, that we teach them, and that we fight. So thank you for your time, and thank you for letting me come to your county.
Especially to the McCorkle family for making this happen on our behalf in McDuffie County. And anyone that has the ability, I would encourage you to go next door to Warren County, because we're going to do it again in just a few minutes.
I need photos of everyone.
If you would like to call y'all, McCorkle family, please get more photo here.
Not just the family, everyone involved.
Yep.
everybody?
Yes.
Perfect. Anyone with you, Vicki Miles? Y'all stay there.
Thank you.
Look, we're staying.
Don't move.
You want to finish or you need to go?
Over the last.
Okay. Yeah, one more. Delicate.
Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
Thank you so much.
Pardon me.
Come on in.
Ten Commandments is the first document. Magna Carta is the next one. Mayflower Compact. Declaration of Independence.
Chris's dad.
The Bill of Rights. The Preamble to the Georgia Constitution. Pardon me. The Star Spangled Banner. Lady Justice. National Motto, In God We Trust.